Hi everyone, welcome again to Blend Tutorials. So we are moving on and going to algebra now. We are doing the first chapter of algebra, which is called as linear equations in two variables. Okay, so what do we mean by each word of the name of this chapter? Linear equations in two variables. What does linear mean? Linear means anything which is in a single line, which is not in a fraction or anything. Equation is nothing but terms which has variables. And what does variables mean? Anything which does not remain constant. For example, now if I write 3x plus 2y is equal to 6. Now if you see this 3, this 2 and this 6, they are called as coefficients. Okay, they are called as coefficients. And these terms x and y are called as variables. Why they are called as variables? Because in this equation, the term variable means that in this equation, x, the value of x and the value of y will remain. For example, suppose we get value of x as 2, value of y as 3. But suppose there is another equation, for example, 3x plus 9y is equal to 9. So the value of x and y in this equation will be something else. That means the value of x and y in every equation does not remain constant, does not remain same, it keeps on changing. That is the reason we say variables. And next is two variables. Two variables doesn't, there are two different alphabets. Either it will be x and y, either it will be 2m plus 3n equal to 9, either it will be 5a minus 3b is equal to 6. Okay, so a, b, m, n, x, y, these are all called as variables. Okay, so now in general form, what we say that ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is called as the general form of a linear equation. That means in general, or if you want to distinguish between linear equation and quadratic equation, a linear equation looks something like this. Here A, B and C are called as coefficients and X and Y are called as variables. Okay. Now, A, B, C coefficient, X, Y variable, but there are some more terms. AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0, where A, B, C obviously coefficients, but they have to be rational numbers. The meaning of this is belongs to rational numbers. Now, what are rational numbers? All numbers, negative numbers, positive numbers, numbers which are having decimals in them, they all are called as rational numbers. Okay, so your A, B, C have to be rational numbers, and A should not be equal to 0 and B should not be equal to 0. Why am I saying this? Suppose in this equation 3x plus 2y equal to 6, 3x plus 2y equal to 6, suppose this x and y, or suppose x was 0. So 3 into 0 plus 2y is equal to 6. So 3 zeros would be 0 plus 2y equal to 6. Now this is not a linear equation, because when anything becomes 0, either this part or this part becomes 0, then we cannot say it is a linear equation. In the similar way, suppose I am saying a coefficient is 0. Ax plus by is equal to c. Suppose I say A or B is equal to 0. So this 0x becomes 0. 0 multiplied by x plus by is equal to c. 0x becomes 0. So x is gone. Okay. So we cannot say that these are called as linear equation, because A and B shouldn't be equal to 0. Now, very clearly understood that Ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Now I can give many examples of linear equations. Some examples of linear equations can be 4m plus 3n is equal to 12, then 0x plus 6y equal to 3. Now if you see here, there is 0, 0x becomes 0, so this cannot be a linear equation. This can be a linear equation. I can give one more example. Now if you see here, 0.3x plus 0y is equal to 36. Now here 0.3x, no problem, because this is a rational number 0.3, so we can say this is a linear equation. But this doesn't specify in linear equation. 0y is equal to 0, so this cannot be a linear इक्वेशन। वन मोर एग्जाम्पल कैन ऑल्सो बी गिवन, रूट टू एक्स माइनस रूट फाइव वाई इज इक्वल टू 16। इफ यू फाइंड आउट विल गेट द आंसर आंसर ऑफ रूट टू, विल इवन गेट द आंसर ऑफ रूट फाइव। सो देयरफॉर दिस रूट टू एक्स, रूट टू वाई, रूट टू फाइव, रूट फाइव वाई, दिस कम इन द क्राइटेरिया ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन वेयर नाउ योर ए इज इक्वल टू रूट टू एंड बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस रूट फाइव। ओके, नाउ वी सी हाउ टू राइट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए बी एंड सी इन अ लीनियर इक्वेशन। सपोज आई एम सेइंग हियर देयर इज 4x प्लस 2y इज इक्वल टू 6। ओके, सो हियर वॉट इज ए इक्वल टू 4, बी इक्वल टू 2। ओके, सो इजिली वी कैन से ए इज 4, बी इज 2। सिमिलरली सपोज आई एम सेइंग 2x माइनस 3y इज इक्वल टू 6, हियर ए विल बी इक्वल टू 2 and b will be equal to, there is a minus sign here, so that's why we call it a b equal to minus 3. Okay, this is just for your knowledge, this won't be required in our sums which we are going to do. Now let's solve one sum. These sums we have even done in our previous standard, that is 9th standard. We'll just try to memorize, re-memorize all these type of sums and remember all these type of sums. Let me take an example. How we used to do such type of sum? 5x plus 3y is equal to 9 and 2x minus 3y is equal to 12. Okay, what we do? We name this as equation 1 and we name this as equation 2. Now, if you see a very important thing, first variable term, or we say the first term we see, are the coefficients equal? No. So, we cannot minus these two. Second term plus 3 minus 3, are the coefficients equal? Yes, the coefficients are equal. So suppose we add this, we can directly 5 plus 2 becomes 7x, 3 minus 3 becomes 0. So this becomes, we don't need to write it, directly we write 9 plus 12, 12 plus 9 is equal to 21. So 7x upon 7 equal to 21 upon 7. So x is equal to 7, 3 is a 21. So we get the value of x. I hope you understood this. Then now x is equal to 3. So we substitute this value in any one of our equations. We can either substitute in this or in this, you will get the same answer. Let me try for both to verify if you are getting the same answer. X is 3. So 5 into 3 plus 3y equal to 9. 15 plus 3y equal to 9. So 3y equal to 9 minus 15. So 3y is equal to minus 6. So y is equal to minus 6 divided by 3 is minus 2. Let us check in this equation. 2x minus 3y equal to 12. So 2 into again 3 minus 3y equal to 12. 2 3s are 6 minus 3y equal to 12. So minus 3y is equal to 12 remains here. We bring this side becomes minus 6. So minus 3y is equal to 6. So y is 6 upon minus 3, that is 2. So minus goes up, y is equal to minus 2. So we either do this or we either do this. We don't need to do both because we'll get the same answer for both, and we'll get the same answer only if you are doing the correct calculations. Extremely important to do the calculations that are perfectly right. Second, a very important thing which I have forgotten, you have to write this. This is therefore. Everywhere it has to be written. There are times when marks are cut for this as well. Okay, the three dots are extremely important. Now you got x, as I said, either this or this, you need to do both. Then now you got x is 3, y is minus 2, therefore we write the final answer. Solution is x comma y, always according to the graph, first x or according to alphabet, first x comes then y. So we write 3 comma minus. This completes our sum. Okay, so we'll be doing some more sums which are related to this part. Now if you see here, we had the same terms, we did not have anything different. Here it was different, so we had to directly add it, no problem here. But here we had the same term, so easily we could minus. So what I did, both in simultaneous equations or in linear equations, we have the freedom of either adding or subtracting. Okay, not division or multiplication. We have only the freedom of either adding or subtracting depending on what we want. Suppose we want y terms to get cut or we want x terms to get cut. इफ योर कैलकुलेशन आर करेक्ट, वॉट एवर मेथड यू डू, यू विल ऑलवेज गेट द सेम आंसर. ओके, सो वॉट विल डू इज, दिस वॉज जस्ट एन इंट्रोडक्टरी लेक्चर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल गो टू सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ सम्स विच वी कैन सॉल्व, विच आर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टाइप्स, बिकॉज इन लीनियर इक्वेशन देर आर मेनी सम्स एंड ऑल द सम्स आर ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप, बट दे हैव द सेम टेक्निक टू डू. सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस पर्टिक्युलर पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर. वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर इन आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. टिल देन टेक केयर, बाय.